Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. Let's take a quick tour of the Azure portal and we'll drill in to some of the key options available. On the left-hand side here is this left navigation pane where you view the different services offered by Azure. Now, these are just your favorites. If you click under More Services, there are even more categorized for easy management, and you can go and pick one or two or 10 and mark them with favorites, and you can also search. On the top bar here, we've got a notification icon, which will tell you about any changes since your last login. It'll give you billing information. We've got a settings option that'll let you pick different themes. Control animations for the portal. And the help button here not only gets you access to your support requests, but also shows you convenient keyboard shortcuts for moving around the portal. Even though it's a web app, it still has some great keyboard shortcuts. Let's click on Marketplace. This is a really important place. It's the complete and comprehensive list of thousands of items from not just Microsoft, but other vendors that can be either purchased or provisioned. You can search everything or explore by category. Now, Azure has a concept called a resource group. This is a container that just holds related resources for an application, and you'll create a resource group with just a few clicks. On the left-hand navigation menu, you can click on New. It'll give you a list of all those services. Currently, the marketplace has more than 3,500 options to choose from across different vendors. So let's search for the type of service that we need. So for example, if I need a virtual machine with SharePoint, I'll filter SharePoint 2016 and we'll create a group from that. There's my resource group name. When you get your resource group just so, you can actually automate creation of it based on an existing resource group. So I'm going to click here on Download Template, and this will give me the template in another form, like for use in the Azure CLI, PowerShell, a .NET application, or even Ruby. A unified and scalable browsing experience makes it easy for you to find the resources that you care about and perform various management operations. So let's explore this left navigation pane a little bit more. I can click on All Resources. That'll give me a complete list of the resources available for a subscription. I can filter and search, and it gives me access to everything: virtual machines, network interfaces, virtual networks, SQL DBs, and so on. Resource groups, those containers that hold other items, can be navigated to. You see here, I've got a cloud service, a couple of virtual machines, a virtual network, all being held in one resource group. Make sure you don't forget, every list has a filter. So if you have a large resource group, you can easily find your way through it. Let's drill into a few different groups and see how management options are consistent. Here's a virtual machine. You can see that there's the overview, the activity log that'll show all the different things that happen in this environment, an access control area that allows me to assign specific roles to users, including support and troubleshooting for boot diagnostics and resetting passwords. Similar management options are seen across different resource types. Here's a SQL database, and it also has an overview and activity logs and different options that I can explore. Very consistent. Here's a virtual network. We see that same management blade. App services, this is where web applications and mobile apps, API apps, and functions exist. They have the same management options as well. So once you know how to manage one resource, you know how to manage them all. One of the things I like about the Azure portal is that the dashboard is totally configurable. It makes for a personal experience. Let's go to one of my web applications, and any one of these tiles I can go and pin to the dashboard. Once that's pinned, not only can it be resized and moved around, but individual charts can be customized. Not only can I customize a dashboard, I can make entirely new dashboards. I can lay it out any way I want and quickly switch between them. The Azure portal is this great unified hub, and it radically simplifies the building, deploying, and managing of all your cloud resources with a single, easy-to-use in-the-browser console. I hope you have as much fun using it as we had building it.